cost is, and here is my flashlight redesign. This is the product before the redesign. It is a dynamo flashlight. It comes in various colors. Its lights are in the nose of the flashlight. It has a bracelet or lanyard for you to hold it, and it comes with a on and off switch and a locking mechanism for the hand press. Reverse engineering challenge. The flashlight is losing market share. So we use interviews, benchmarking, functional models, and disassembly. Customer interviews, examples. Alright, here's some of the questions that we ask customers. What do you think of the cranking noise? They felt that it was too noisy and it was a factor of whether they buy it or not. What do you think about the amount of light use? They felt it was too dim and they wish it would just be brighter. How much light would you pay? How much money would you pay for the flashlight? Nobody would pay anything over $5. They didn't feel it was worth the money. And what do you think about the material of the flashlight? It felt cheap. They didn't like the material of the flashlight at all. What would you use this flashlight for? A lot of people would just buy this for their kids as a distraction. Yes, nobody wanted this for personal use. They wanted this for themselves. All right, flashlight benchmarking. We use smart probes to find the light's duration and its sound output. A triple beam balance scale for the weight of the flashlight and a ruler for its dimensions. Alright, and here's some of the examples from the benchmarking. The average light duration was at 200 beats per minute was 1.16 seconds. The average sound output was 84.6 decibels. The dimensions for the flashlight originally was 10.5 centimeters by 7 centimeters by 4.5 centimeters. Its weight was 63 grams. All right, and here's our black box model. Our product is a shining light. Our inputs were from our hand and electricity. Our outputs were light, sound, and vibration. This is without the knowledge of the workings of the flashlight internally. We use this for brainstorming and help us generate more ideas for making a new flashlight. Energy flow diagram. It starts off with your hand energy, which then transfers to mechanical energy, mechanical to electrical, electrical to light energy, and then shining light. Given the information from the functional models, we made improvements with the flashlight redesign. We know that you're going to use your hands to produce the mechanical energy, so we brought hand grips so you could better do so, and then mechanical to electrical energy. We've changed the gear ratio so you're using less turns to produce more electricity. Electrical to light energy. We're using LED bulbs. Using less electrical energy, and that's for our shining. Flashlight final redesign. The flashlight is longer. It is now alligator shaped. It is green. It has a on and off switch and a locking mechanism that is now labeled. The hand press is the same as before. It just has a and when operated, the light shines with the alligator's mouth open. It has a speaker, ports along its backside, and a seal for the ports. And that's the retractable light here on its tail. Flashlight features, it's LED bulbs, retractable lanyard, auxiliary port, seals for the ports to prevent water dust from entering, labeling, rubber grip, and soundproof walls for less noisy output. original and redesign specifications. Here are some of the variables, which were noise, its weight, flux, crank force, width, its length, its plastic material, the lanyard bracelet, and its light duration. For the original, it was 84.6 decibels. They felt that it was too noisy, so we brought it down to 50 decibels. Its weight was 63 grams. That was really a factor, so we brought it up to 100 grams. Its lux was 3.43 lux. It needed to be improved, so we brought it to 50 lux at 50 centimeters, so it's brighter. Its crank force was 14.6 newtons, which is now brought up down to 10 newtons. So you use less hand energy to produce the mechanical energy. Its width wasn't really a factor. It's 4.5 centimeters on the original, and it's now 6 to 5.5 centimeters. The length was 10.5 centimeters, and is now 16 to 18 centimeters. The material on the original was thin and cheap filling, so it is now bigger and more durable. The bracelet for the flashlight. On the original, it had a non-stretch material, which made it hard for your hands to fit in the bracelet, and is now with a stretch material, so you can better do so. The light duration for the flashlight is 1.16 seconds at 200 beats per minute. That's on the original, whenever it was a dynamo flashlight. It is now a rechargeable flashlight with a battery that holds a full charge